clear message. If you lie to the special counsel, there will be consequences.
Mm-hmm. The Washington Post is also reporting, they're saying that the legal experts have warned any potential testimony could make the president a target. We've heard the president say that he'd love to speak to Mueller, but do you think that would be a bad idea, Jennifer?
For him to speak to Mueller?
Yeah.
A terrible idea. I mean, if I were his lawyer, I'd say, heck no. I mean, you know, what we are seeing him.
But you'd be John Dowd and you'd be gone.
Right, I'm sure I would be. But really, I know he pretends like he's so confident, but really, I think what Anna is saying, and I think you see it in the dissembling on the tweets that he continues to put out, which contains so many falsehoods, is that he is freaked out about this. And he shouldn't, I think for the American people, it'd be great if he testified, but I do think that he would put himself in significant jeopardy.
Yeah. Mike, the Washington Post also reporting the special counsel told Trump's lawyers that he is preparing a report about the president's actions while in office, and potential obstruction of justice. Would Mueller need to write a report if the president didn't do anything wrong?
Yeah, because could exonerate him. And I think that's what many of us on here have said. One of the reasons why we would not recommend that he fire the special counsel is because you want the special counsel to issue that report so you can find out exactly what he didn't do. I mean, look, we've been at this for over a year. There isn't any evidence yet that anyone has seen that the president colluded with Russia or obstructed justice. There's been nothing that we've seen that proves any of that sort of thing. And in fact, the news tonight is kind of what we already know. The president's not a target of a criminal investigation. He's a subject, which means they want to talk to him. We already knew that. We knew that he was negotiating with Mueller to sit down and figure out exactly how it was that he would testify. And you guys are saying the president's sort of worried or scared. I think the president's angry. I think he's trying to get on with the nation's business and do what 63 million Americans asked him to do. And instead, we have this very slow evolving investigation where there's not been anything other than minor people like today getting indicted out of the whole thing. So I think he'd like it to speed up and get over with, and I think writing a report will help exonerate him. He should want
Mike,
that.
Mike, two things here, just for just for facts for the audience. We don't know if there's evidence of collusion or not. There could be none, but we don't know what the evidence that Robert Mueller has. So you can't say definitively that there's nothing that points to collusion or obstruction of justice. The evidence just does not show that at this point.
I agree.
So we don't know.
There is no evidence yet, right?
Yeah, there's no evidence.
Well, where there necessarily
we don't know if there's evidence yet. I'm not saying that there is no evidence. My point is that we don't know what Robert Mueller is doing. And the president has insisted that and the White House from the podium that the president is not under investigation. This report is saying the president is under investigation. He is not a target. He is a subject of the investigation. I just wanted to clarify that for the people out there.
Means he's a part of the investigation, which I just think it's important to use words. Saying you're under investigation.
That's what it says.
It's saying you're a part of the investigation.
The headline says Mueller told Trump's attorneys the president remains under investigation. That means he's under investigation, but is not currently a criminal target. I just want to make those facts clear. So Anna, President Trump vowed to drain the swamp, but we are learning more and more about his EPA Administrator Scott Pruitt's decision to rent a room in Washington, D.C. from the family of an energy lobbyist. I think it was like $50 a night, well below what any room would be. Does that seem swampy to you?
Everything seems swampy to me. Look, we've been amazed as American people to see the level of chivalry, the level of, you know, nonchalance with which these cabinet secretaries spend taxpayer money. And it's very important that we not get used to it. I think it's very important that we keep scrutinizing these cabinet secretaries. Not the president and not the cabinet are above the law. And it is, unacceptable for people to be spending $31,000 on a lunch table, for people to be spending $140,000 on a set of doors, for people to be pushing the envelope and, you know, blurring the lines of ethics and propriety with things like the rental of this apartment. We must demand transparency. It was part of the reason why so many people voted for Donald Trump, because he was supposed to clean this up. He was supposed to drain the swamp. He was supposed to bring in a new level of transparency. And frankly, he has so many rich people in his cabinet, everybody thought, well, great. Nobody's going to be doing any corrupt acts. And instead, what we've seen is nothing but corruption. Listen, I was in San Francisco this weekend. I was at the Academy of Sciences. I was looking at the swamp things there, and I couldn't tell the difference between what I was seeing in the aquarium and what I was seeing in Washington. I saw an albino alligator.
The only one who's not laughing is Mike. So, Mike, I'll ask you. CNN is learning that Trump called Pruitt last night and told him, quote, we got your back. Do you believe that? Because we heard that and then they're gone within a couple of days or a couple of weeks.
Yeah, look, I mean, I think anyone who's in the president's cabinet knows that they could be gone at any moment. He'll switch them out for somebody until he thinks they're doing the right job. And that's what the American people are fine with that. That's why term limits have always been so popular, because we're fine with getting rid of politicians until they do the things that we want. Look, I think one of the interesting things, I believe that it's a former lobbyist, not a current lobbyist. I think it's worth noting that he's been running this from. And I think also it's worth pointing out a lot of the scrutiny around Pruitt that the media has been covering about, for instance, how much money he spends on travel, and yet it paled in comparison to what his predecessor in the Obama administration paid for travel, and yet we didn't seem to have a lot of these stories. So I think part of that is because the president here is to drain the swamp, so it's fair to say when someone's doing something, you're going to talk about it. But I do also think that...
Wasn't he supposed to be doing better than... If you say you're going to drain the swamp,
that's my point.
Can't compare to the previous administration.
But, I think a little objectivity in the media to cover a cabinet secretary's travel and to say that it hadn't been covered before is worth pointing out.
Let me ask you this. You live in D.C., right?
Outside D.C.
You live outside D.C. So if you want to stay in the city for a night, how much do you think you'd pay for a hotel room?
Well, look, this is not a cheap city. Okay. There's no question.
So $50 from a former lobbyist, you cool with that?
Well, I don't know the details of that, and I think it's probably being looked into. It's a...
On the surface, $50 from a former lobbyist per night, are you cool with that?
If there's no quid pro quo, if there's nothing that's being given in exchange for it, then there's nothing wrong with it. You can stay in a friend's basement. You can stay with a relative. There's nothing wrong with that if there's no quid pro quo, if there's nothing being given to the secretary
I pay for hotel rooms in Washington. You are lucky to get anything for under $250. For $50 a night, you couldn't even rent a park bench.
Well, okay. Sure, of course.
Hold that thought. I got to get to the break.
Have you ever stayed at a friend's house?
I got to get to the break. Well, if he's a friend, then that's a whole other thing. Friends with a former lobbyist. But, I mean, come on. All right. We'll be back. Don't go anywhere. We got a lot to talk about. I'm back now with Jennifer Granholm, Anna Navarro, and Mike Shields. So, Jennifer, for the past 48 hours, the president has been using the harsh and emotional language in his tweets and appearances. He calls President Obama cheating Obama. He says we have pathetic immigration laws. He says news organizations have a sick and biased agenda, and people who don't condemn Amazon are fools or worse. He's fired up on all things about Russia. So what is going on?
Yeah, I mean, he is...
And most of it's not factual.
Right. I mean, that's, to me, I mean, first of all, it's so unpresidential, whatever that means, right? So people sent him there because maybe they didn't want somebody who was presidential. On my way in today, I talked to one of the guys who wrote The Leadership Challenge, which is the biggest selling leadership book for the past 25 years. And they have surveyed hundreds of thousands of people to ask them, what are the qualities in a leader that you would willingly follow? You know what the number one quality is among all over the world? This is Jim Kuzis. The number one quality that people want is honesty. That is the number one quality. So I said to him, how could this be that everybody says they want leaders who are honest, and yet we have somebody who has been documented lying thousands of times by the fact checkers all across the country? How can it be?
Well, he said that Amazon only fools are... when he talked about Amazon, he said Amazon doesn't pay taxes. Amazon started paying taxes in 2014. Right. He says Amazon is costing the post office more money. The post office, right. Amazon is keeping the post office afloat.
Right.
And they're paying taxes in places wherever.
Four lies. Four Pinocchio lies. So in Amazon, in fact, the delivery service for Amazon and packages has been the one sector that has really grown for the post office. The post office must charge people what it costs them to deliver or more. They don't take, their taxpayers are not paying for Amazon delivery through the post office.
Well, and the president cannot compel Amazon to pay more money because it operates independently through the Postmaster General.
Who just approved the latest fees for the delivery service.
And so then cheating Obama.
Honestly,
probably the squeakiest president we've had in modern history. President McBlackman could not make a mistake without people jumping on him.
Right, the biggest scandal was him wearing a tan
suit. Let me tell you something, not to mention that if there is one word Donald Trump should not throw at any other man right now, it's the
cheating.
Word okay? I mean, that's one that he should just strike from the vocabulary right now. Look, I think what we're seeing is that he was pretty quiet there for a few days while the entire Stormy Daniels thing was brewing and was playing out on TV. That's the only time we've seen silence from him for years now. And the thing built up in his system so that it exploded over the weekend. This guy was going into Easter service and started spewing off crazy, inaccurate lies about DACA. He's been tweeting crazy stuff since he exploded like a volcano after keeping silence with Stormy.
If he's going to explode on Twitter, which
Bring
is his right,
back.
Right? Shouldn't he at least have his facts correct about it?
Well, look, I think the president, obviously, we know, uses Twitter to communicate to the American people and set debates, and then everyone on our
But shouldn't
panel
he communicate
gets,
facts?
Shouldn't it be truthful,
what he tweets? He shouldn't tweet out things that are lies, that are not factual, get the American people all upset, have a lot of people believing that it's actually true when it's just not accurate. That's not informing people as a president. He's actually making them dumber.
Yeah, look, I mean, he's going to get fact-checked, right? So, I mean, and we've been saying this about the president's tweets for quite a while, and they get fact-checked on television, and he keeps doing it. So, obviously, he believes in doing something else, which is
so you're okay with that.
He's lying.
You're okay with the president. You're okay with people not telling the truth.
I believe that the president should do a little bit more research before he hits the send button. There's no question about that. And I think it does him a disservice when that happens.
Okay.
However, I also believe that most of the people that are experiencing the president's economy that are doing better don't care about a lot of this noise. This winds up being noise that we end up talking about.
But that doesn't matter.
Where
we should all care about the truth.
But we should care.
We should care if the president of the United States tells the truth.
We should care. This is one of the things, Mike, I think it's
I gotta
so
go,
important
Anna.
That regardless of party, we don't numb ourselves to believing and accepting that this is normal.
Okay,
it is
I gotta
not,
go.
And he is cheapening the presidency of the United States.